Why do left-handers exist? If you look at the percentage, you'll see that it makes no sense that the number has never dropped. And if both of their hands seem fully capable, just near to each other, why are we so bad with one of them? Our brains are crosswired, meaning the left side controls the right hand and vice versa. The right hemisphere is responsible for visual speech and attention, while the left hemisphere controls language and motor abilities. This makes left-handers much more variable in the way that their brains are organized. While this relationship is not straightforward, in most cases, handedness and brain lateralization go hand in hand. If both hands are fully capable, both sides of the brain will need an entirely different circuit spending time and energy on the same thing. And training the limb to write decently would take even more. It all comes down to efficiency. The dominance of some cognitive process on one side of the brain is associated with improved cognitive ability. But what about lefties? A gene so fiercely dominates right-handedness, which has been around since the Neanderthals, would have forced the recessive gene, and left-handedness would have been out of the gene pool a long time ago. Yet, the percentage isn't decreasing like it theoretically should. The reason is still being figured out, but scientists believe your hand preference is influenced by many factors, like genetics, environment, and even random chance. But whether it's on tennis court or on a tatami, right-handers do worse on facing lefties. If you happen to be holding a sword, for example, being a lefty is also a great survival tool. But that would only work if it only a tiny percentage of us had it. Which may explain why this percentage has been the same for so long. While there are many disadvantages to being a lefty, as well as some unfair meanings to the words left and right in so many languages, there are also a lot of myths and misconceptions about it. All of my research is linked below. Bye!